मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द अनादर यूनिट, द सेकेंड यूनिट ऑफ द फिजिकल केमिस्ट्री, दैट इज अ केमिकल थर्मोडायनामिक्स। इन द केमिकल थर्मोडायनामिक्स देयर इज अ कॉलिगेटिव प्रॉपर्टीज, थ्री कॉलिगेटिव प्रॉपर्टीज वी हैव टू सी, दैट इज अ एलिवेशन इन द बॉइलिंग पॉइंट, डिप्रेशन इन द फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट, ऑस्मोटिक प्रेशर। In the starting of this unit, we have to see the VP, means the vapor pressure, and relative lowering of the VP, that is the relative lowering of the vapor pressure, and its measurement by the static and dynamic method. Then we have see solutions of the solid in the liquid, elevation and the boiling point, their thermodynamic derivation. Then depression in the freezing point, their thermodynamic derivation. And how we can determine that particular depression in the freezing point by using the Beckmann method and the Rost method. We have to see the numericals also. Then the osmotic pressure, we have to see their derivation, Van't Hoff's equation, then Van't Hoff's factor, then measurement of the osmotic pressure by the Berkeley and Hartley method, and last concept is the reverse osmosis. The second part of this unit is a chemical kinetics, in that we have to see the CT, their assumptions, their applications to the unimolecular theory, that is a unimolecular reaction and a bimolecular reaction. When we apply CT for the unimolecular reaction, it is called as a Lindemann's theory. Then the classification of the reaction, as we have to see, slow reaction, fast reaction, ultra fast reaction. Then their study of the kinetics of the fast reaction by the Stofflow method and the flash photolysis, that we have to see. This is a part of the unit 2 that we have to see throughout this particular lectures. Today we are going to start the chemical thermodynamics, in that colligative properties. Now what are the colligative properties? The properties which, these are the properties of the dilute solution, which depends on only the number of solute molecules and not on the type or the chemical nature of the species present, are called as a colligative properties. Example, relative lowering of the vapor pressure, elevation in the boiling point, depression in the freezing point, osmotic pressure. While starting this unit, we have to focus on the few terms, that is the solution, what is a solvent, what is a solute, what is a dilute solution, what is a molarity, like that. First of all, you should know the solution. It is nothing but a homogeneous phase that contains more than one component. Solution is a homogeneous phase which contains the more than one component. Then what is the solvent? That the portion of the solution, or say component of the solution, which present in the greater proportion is called as a solvent. The component which is present in the lesser proportion in a solution is called as a solute. Then what is the dilute solution? A solution which contains small amount of the solute as compared to the solvent is known as the dilute solution. When we call it dilute solution, there should be the more solvent and less solute. Then molarity, number of moles of the solute per 1000 cm cube, or say 1 dm cube of a solution, is known as the molarity. Then what is the molality? Number of moles of the solid per 1000 gram or 1 kilogram of solution is known as the molality. What is the mole fraction? Mole fraction of a component in a solution is the number of moles of that component present divided by the total number of moles of all the components in the solution. If we are considered two components are there, one is a solute and another is a solvent, that is the x1 and x2, then the mole fraction of the solute x2 will be the n2 divided by n1 plus n2, that is a number of moles of the solute divided by number of moles of the solvent plus number of moles of the solute. Mole fraction of the solvent x1 is equal to n1 divided by n1 plus n2. Then what is the ideal solution? A solution which can be prepared from its component with no evolution or absorption of heat, with no change in volume, and the one which obeys the Rolle's law under all conditions is called as ideal solution. All dilute solution behaves as an ideal solution.
the solution which obeys the Rolle's law is called as the ideal solution, and the solution which does not obey the Rolle's law or say criteria for the ideal solution is called as a non-ideal or say real solution. Moderate and high concentrations are behave as a non-ideal solution. These are the few terms that we have to know. We should know what we have seen. First of all, what is a colligative property? That we should know always. Colligative properties, these are the properties of the dilute solution which depends only on the number of solutes, molecules, and not on the type or the chemical nature of the species present are called as the colligative properties. Example, relative lowering of vapor pressure, elevation in the boiling point, depression in the freezing point, and osmotic pressure. These are the examples of the colligative property. You have to mind it well. Then we have focus on the few terminology. What is a solution? What is a solvent? What is a solute? Solution, I said, it is a homogeneous phase that contains more than one component. Then and there only it will become the solution. Otherwise, solution will not be formed. There should be the either solute or solvent like that. Then we have seen the solvent. A major proportion or say a component which is present in the greater proportion in the solution is called as a solvent, and a component which is present in the lesser or say low amount in the solution is called as a solute. Dilute solution is nothing but a solution which contained amount of the solute is very small as compared to the solvent is known as the dilute solution. Then we have see the molarity. Number of moles of that solute per 1000 cm cube or say 1 dm cube of the solution is nothing but the molarity. And what is the molarity? Number of moles of the solute per 1000 gram or say 1 kilogram of the solution is known as the molarity. Then we have seen the mole fraction of a component in the solution is the number of moles of that component divided by total number of moles of all the components in the solution. Then the mole fraction of the solute and the mole fraction of the solvent that we have seen. Then what is the ideal solution? The which solution which obeys the Rolle's law under all conditions is called as the ideal solution. All dilute solutions are ideal solution. Non-ideal solution, the solution which does not obey the Rolle's law is called as the non-ideal solution or say real solution. Example, moderate and high concentration solutions behaves as a non-ideal solution. Got this point? Now we will today focus on the vapor pressure or relative lowering of the vapor pressure. Vapor pressure of the liquid depends upon the nature of the liquid. Second, temperature. Now, nature of the liquid, in that liquid with the weak intermolecular forces have the greater vapor pressure. Liquid with the weak intermolecular forces have the greater vapor pressure and they are more volatile. You will get the what is the volatile definition of the volatile. The liquid with the weak intermolecular forces have the greater vapor pressure. They will vaporize fast. They are called as the volatile, and which vaporize slowly, they are called as the non-volatile or say less volatile. Liquid with the strong intermolecular forces have smaller VP, they are less volatile. Then the temperature, as the temperature increases, more molecules evaporates and go into the vapor phase, hence vapor pressure increases with increasing temperature. Solution, solution of electrolyte, solution of non-electrolyte, what will happen? Solute dissociate into ions, and in the non-electrolyte solute remains in the molecular state or electrically neutral state. Two types of the solution is there. One is the solution of the electrolyte and another is the solution of the non-electrolyte. What will happen in the when the electrolyte we are taking, that means it dissociate into its corresponding ions, whereas we are taking non-electrolyte, it will not dissociate, it will remain it in the molecular state or electrically neutral state. Now we have to see, explain the term relative lowering of vapor pressure. How it's related to the mole fraction of the solute, or so state Rolle's law and give the relevant relationship. This is again the one question. When non-volatile solute is dissolved in the solvent, the vapor pressure of the solvent is lower. Rolle's law gives the quantitative relationship between lowering of vapor pressure and the composition of the solution. Rolle's law states that the relative lowering of vapor pressure of the solvent on addition of the non-volatile solute is equal to the mole fraction of the solute in the solution, that is P0 minus P by P0 is equal to X2, where P0 is vapor pressure of the PR solvent at a given temperature, P is the vapor pressure of the solution at given temperature, then P0 minus P upon P is nothing but a relative lowering of vapor pressure, and X2 is the mole fraction of the solute. When solute is dissolved in the solvent, vapor pressure is lower. The magnitude of lowering of vapor pressure is given as P0 minus P upon P0 is equal to delta P upon P0 is equal to N2 divided by N1 plus N2. From this equation, we can predict that the relative lowering of the vapor pressure is equal to the mole fraction of the solute in the solution. Relative lowering of the vapor pressure is colligative property because it is independent on either nature of the solute or solvent, but depends only on the amount of the solute in the solution. What is the Rolle's law? Sometime the question may ask on this, and how you can determine. Two methods are there, static method and the dynamic method, that we have to see. First of all, we will focus on this Rolle's law. What happens? See, you can see. Generally, when we are preparing the tea, okay, leave that part. See, take in the one petri dish the alcohol, and in the another petri dish take the any liquid dissolved in the alcohol. See, you will see that, you will observe that the alcohol, which is the pure alcohol, which is you are spreading fast, and the alcohol with the another component is evaporating with the less. The vapor pressure of this alcohol, pure alcohol, is more than the that added adulterated alcohol. Getting that point? What is that? Explain the term relative lowering of the vapor pressure, how it is related to the mole fraction of the solute. State the Rolle's law, give the relevant relationship between them. Then, when the non-volatile solute is dissolved in the solvent, the vapor pressure of the solvent is lowered. Rolle's law gives the quantitative relationship between the lowering of vapor pressure and the composition of the solution, or say you can call it as a concentration. Rolle's law states that the relative lowering of vapor pressure of solvent on addition of non-volatile solute is equal to the mole fraction of the solute in the solution, that is P0 minus P upon P0 is equal to X2. This P0 minus P upon P0 is nothing but a relative lowering of vapor pressure. P0 is the vapor pressure of the pure solvent at a given temperature, whereas P is the vapor pressure of the solution at given temperature. That you have to remember well. This relation is very much important. Then X2 is the mole fraction of the solute. When the solute is dissolved in the solvent, vapor pressure is lowered. The magnitude of the lowering of vapor pressure is given as, you can rewrite this equation as P0 minus P upon P0 is equal to delta P upon P0 is equal to N2 upon N1 plus N2. From this equation, we can predict that the relative lowering of vapor pressure is equal to the mole fraction of the solute in the solution. Therefore, relative lowering of the vapor pressure is a colligative property because it is independent on either the nature of the solute or solvent, but depends only on the amount of the solute in the solution. Please prepare this part well. Sometime the question will be on the relative lowering of vapor pressure, elevation in the boiling point, depression in the freezing point, numericals will be there based on the osmotic pressure, reverse osmosis is there. Then the CT, in the CT, unimolecular theory, bimolecular theory, they may ask, and the fast reaction, study of the kinetics of the fast reaction by the flash photolysis or say stop flow method. This sometime the question will be on this part. Very simple unit it is also. Please go through well. If you have any problem, you can freely ask.